Welcome to the book, A Path Towards Light, written by Amin Sayedi. All images and narrator audio generated by AI, so please forgive us if you notice any flaws. But don't worry! We're improving every day and striving to provide the best possible experience for you. So come along on this thrilling journey and enjoy the journey!
Introduction. The story begins in the village of Ira. Ira is a small, peaceful village nestled among the green mountains and dense forests of the country of Venner. The village's houses are made of stone and wood, with gabled, two-story roofs. The village's streets are narrow and paved, with colorful flowers planted on their sides.
People of Ira earn their living through agriculture and animal husbandry. They grow wheat, barley, and potatoes in their fields and raise sheep, cows, and horses in their pastures. They also produce various handicrafts such as weaving, basketry, and pottery. But what distinguishes Ira from other villages is that one of the best martial arts schools in the country is located there. This school is run by Master John, a skilled and experienced master. The Academy of Master John is a large and old building located on top of a hill in the highlands of Ira. The building is reached by a long flight of stairs. The school building is made of stone and wood, and the roof is also tiled. The school has a large courtyard and several courtyards. At the end of the school, at the top of the hill, there is a large and tall tree called Eridan. The tree, with its long branches and dark green leaves, hides the stunning view of the mountain and the valley behind it. On sunny days, sunlight shines through the leaves of the tree and creates beautiful and intricate shadows. Eridan Tree is a quiet and beautiful place to relax and meditate. In the legends of Ira, there is a tree called Eridan. It is said that the tree was planted by a powerful wizard and has magical properties. Anyone who sits under the shade of Eridan is said to gain wisdom and power. Eridan is an ancient and powerful tree that has been there for centuries. The legend of Eridan is a reminder that power lies in knowledge and wisdom. Those who are willing to learn and grow can gain power and make the world a better place. So, in Ira, the great tree was not just a tree, but a sacred place where people came for peace and to pray under its wide shade. The Academy of Master John is a quiet and cozy place that is considered ideal for martial arts training. The interior of the academy is covered with mats and martial arts weapons. In the corner of the courtyard, there is also a large fireplace where students gather around in the cold winters to chat and joke with each other. The fireplace provides warmth and a pleasant light to the academy, and the students feel relaxed and safe next to it. They sit by the fire for hours telling stories, singing songs, and practicing. The Academy of Master John is a place where students can learn and grow not only the way of fighting, but everything about the way of life. Master John was a middle-aged man of average height with white, thinning hair. He had black eyes and a kind face. He was a skilled warrior and was held in high regard by the villagers. He was an experienced martial arts master who was known for his discipline and order. He also believed that fighting was a way to peace and to repel evil. John was a middle-aged and experienced martial arts master who had been teaching martial arts to his students for many years. He was a kind and compassionate man, but he was also very strict and demanding. He believed that the only way to learn real martial arts was through hard work and dedication. Master John was not just an ordinary master. He had fought with most styles of martial arts and was familiar with most fighting techniques in the world. He was also a well-known figure in the art and founded the martial arts tournament in the country, and every year he brought many warriors to the tournament. The people of Ira are kind and hospitable and love martial arts. They send their children to learn martial arts at Master John S. Academy and participate in Master John S. Martial Arts Tournament every year. This tournament is an important event for the village, and people from all over the country come to Ira to participate in it. The people of Ira host their guests with pride and make this tournament an unforgettable experience for everyone. Master John S. Martial Arts Tournament is a colorful and vibrant event. People wear their traditional clothes and celebrate with drums and music. The tournament is held in a large field located at Master John S. Academy, and people of all ages gather to watch it. The event is a great place for warriors from all over the country to show off their skills and compete against each other. People from all over the country come to Ira to watch the fights, bet on the outcome, and enjoy the beautiful scenery of the village. The village has become a popular holiday destination, and people from all walks of life come here to experience the thrill and excitement of the fights. But the country of Venner was ruled by a man named Blank, a cruel and oppressive man. He always caused trouble for the people and imposed new tax laws. The people were tired of this and could barely tolerate him. Blank, the despotic and ambitious ruler of Vanir, constantly thought of heavy taxes to be able to finance his army and conquer neighboring lands by attacking them. He wanted to rule over more lands and put his dream of ruling in the ends of the world. One of Blank's problems was that he always imposed new taxes. These taxes were very heavy for the people, and they could not afford to pay for their living. Many people were forced to sell their houses and fell into poverty day by day. Another problem of Blank was that he always harassed people who paid less taxes and imprisoned or even tortured and executed his political opponents. But the people of the village of Ira were not very worried about Blank, because they were exempt from taxes, and this was because of Master John. He had introduced the fighting techniques to most of the people of Ira and the surrounding villages, and he considered himself the leader of the security of the people of that region. He opposed the heavy taxes for the government and encouraged the people to not pay taxes and resist force. The ruler of the country, Blank, had refrained from collecting taxes from the village of Ira. Because to collect the small taxes of this village, he had to pay a huge amount and face armed and ready to war people, and this was not practical until the death of Master John, and the military attack was not economically profitable for him. Master John was opposed to Blank's heavy taxes, as he knew that they would make people poorer, and he believed that people should be free and live freely. Blank was very angry about this, but his advisors told him that he should be more patient and wait for the right opportunity to resolve this issue, as Master John was a popular and well-liked man, and tension with him could even incite people to rebellion. The village of Ira was initially a small village, but the tax-free law of this village had attracted many villagers from all over the country, and now this village has a population of hundreds of people and is one of the most crowded villages in the world today.
Master John had a son named Garner. Garner's mother died of an illness when he was a child, and the responsibility of raising him fell entirely on Master John. His father taught him martial arts since he was a child, and he also learned martial arts well. However, in the absence of his mother, he gradually became a proud and selfish young man. He was against his father teaching martial arts to everyone, believing that the art should remain in the family as a legacy. He would say, "Let the people do their own farming and animal husbandry. You are obliged to teach only me and no one else." Master John had a different belief. He believed that everyone, whether male, female, old, or young, should learn how to fight and use it to defend themselves or others. He said, "A fighter in a farmer's clothes is better than a farmer in a fighter's clothes." This led to a gradual escalation of disagreements between the father and son, and they started to argue. Master John was disappointed and heartbroken to see that his disagreement with his only son Garner was growing day by day. He loved Garner very much, but he was afraid that something bad would happen to him without him and that he might go astray and not have a happy ending. Master John remembered a time when Garner was a sweet and kind boy who loved to learn. He was always asking questions and was eager to know about the world around him. But in the past few years, Garner had changed. He had become aggressive and angry, and he was unwilling to listen to advice or hear from others. Master John didn't know what to do. He had tried to talk to Garner, but Garner would not listen to him. He had even tried to get Garner counseling, but Garner would not talk to his father. Garner was hard at training most of the time and wanted to be the best in the fight to get everyone's attention. He thought that if he was the best fighter, everyone would respect him and accept him as a leader. He wanted to impress everyone and show that he is better and smarter than everyone. In one of the training exercises, in the presence of his father, he fights with one of his classmates named Ulysses to prove himself to Master John and all his classmates, as if he is on the battlefield and his classmate Ulysses is his enemy. Unfortunately, Ulysses was seriously injured and bad things could have happened if Master John had not intervened. Master John, his face red with anger, grabbed Garner's hand and pulled him to the corner of the class. In a loud voice, he said, "This is no way to practice fighting. You must be more careful. This is just a practice fight, not a war." Garner, completely unremorseful about his actions, said, "Fighting is just this. The weak get defeated and the strong become victorious. A warrior must be ready to die." Master John angrily stared into Garner's eyes. His hair stood on end from rage and the veins in his neck protruded. He knew he could no longer control or correct Garner. Without another word, he left the martial arts class in despair. After that incident, Master John allowed Garner to fight less often. Because he no longer fully trusted him and didn't want anything bad to happen to others. As punishment, Garner was only allowed to practice for a limited time with the wooden training dummy that was in the corner of the class, separate from his other classmates. Garner was very disappointed and angry about his father's punishment. He didn't understand why his father was being so harsh and limiting towards him. He thought to himself that Master John was hindering his progress and didn't want his son to surpass him. Soon, the annual martial arts competition arrived as usual. Warriors from all over the country gathered at Master John's Academy to compete. This was an important event, and people came from all over to spectate. They were of all ages and professions, but had one thing in common: a love for martial arts. On this day, people came to see the best fighting from the country's warriors. The people wanted to witness their skills and strengths, and see who would win the medal. The day of battle was exciting and thrilling. The people trembled and shouted when they saw the warriors. They were happy with the victories of their own warriors, and disappointed by their defeats. It was a day when love for martial arts was celebrated. It was a day when people took pleasure in seeing the best warriors of the country. But this didn't apply to Garner, because his father had banned him from participating in the competition. Garner knew that if he missed this competition, he'd have to wait a whole year, something he really didn't want. He hated waiting and was very angry and upset about this. His ears were red with anger and he clenched his teeth tightly. He couldn't believe his father had taken away his chance of winning. He had trained for years for this moment, and now all his dreams vanished before his eyes. Garner was only allowed to sit on the platform beside his father and watch the matches from afar. He felt intense jealousy and hatred. He watched his classmates compete while he could only spectate. On the morning of the fighting day, after an opening symbolic ceremony, Master John stood before the crowd and gave a short, loud speech about it, saying, "The day of battle is a day when we come together to celebrate the martial arts. It is a day when we showcase our skills and strengths, find our weaknesses, and share our strong points. Martial arts are tools for defending oneself and others. They are tools for establishing peace, not creating violence. We must use our martial arts to protect those we love and build a better world. Let us celebrate peace and respect on this battle day. Let us use our martial arts to build a better world." The crowd was moved by Master John's speech, and it evoked even more excitement in them. His words were heartfelt and touching, and people knew he was a wise, kind man whose words came from the bottom of his heart. The warriors went to the battlefield after drawing lots to choose their opponents, and the fighting began. The battles lasted for days as the warriors fought to achieve victory. They fought with various weapons, from swords and shields to spears and shields. The fighting was brutal and bloody, but it always ultimately ended with peace and respect. At the end of each battle, one warrior was declared the winner and would face off against warriors from other days in a final battle, so that ultimately one person would be declared the final winner and receive a medal and the respect of all. Finally, the final battle began and 5 out of the 100 participants had made it to the final battle. The day of battle was a long and difficult day, and all 5 warriors showed signs of fatigue and injuries, but each of them was determined that they could be the winner of the battles and receive the medal for themselves. The competition began and the 5 warriors quickly attacked each other. Each had a sword and a shield, and they struck each other with fists and kicks and the weapons they held, trying to defeat their opponents. The battle was difficult and lengthy, and all 5 warriors fought hard. The sun burned in the sky and dust rose from the warriors' feet. They battled in the arena for a full hour, but only one warrior remained. That was Spark, the young warrior from the village of Astria. Finally, Spark was able to defeat his last enemy and become the champion of this round of competitions. He stood and looked at the crowd that had gathered to cheer his glorious victory. He had earned the reward for all his hard work and felt joy, pride and satisfaction. As Spark stood with his hands raised toward the spectators and shouted, "I became the champion of these battles." Suddenly Garner's son rose from his place and loudly shouted, spark, I am your opponent. Your battle is not yet over and you are not the true champions.